Hello, BookTube, this time in 2018, with me, Sarah.
And me, Rebecca.
I can't be a news anchor.
No, that was great. You're a really good news anchor.
So, today, BookTube, we're talking about our 2018 reading checklists. There are goals in a very checklisty format. Number one is how many books total we plan on reading in the year. I plan on reading 60 books this year, which you're gonna see that all of my goals are much more modest. Not just than you, I know that not just than you personally, but then a lot of people on BookTube, and that's for twofold. One, I am a slow reader. And I have a lot of other interests, music and writing, and and I'll be working.
I'm hoping to read 90 books this year.
Just aim for what makes you feel accomplished.
Don't
have to think about what anyone else.
Yeah, for sure.
For number two, I personally want to read two bestsellers, but like, well, they're bestsellers. I want to read like something current bestseller.
Okay.
I want to read whatever everyone is reading at the time.
My number two is to read the books that I added to my TBR the year I joined Goodreads, which was 2014. So these books have been on my TBR for almost 4 years. So there's nine of them, and I'm just going to list them off real quick.
Yeah.
The first one's Feed by Mira Grant, Cassidy Jones and the Secret Formula by Elise Stokes, Hero by Perry Moore, Raising Stoney Mayha by Daryl Gregory, Kin by Patrick Keelan Burke, Shades of Grey by Jasper Ford, not 50 Shades of Grey.
Just some Shades of Grey.
Shades of Grey. An unknown number
or an infinite number. All
the Shades of Grey. Ex-Heroes by Peter Kleins, The Diviners by Libba Bray, and Luck in the Shadows by Lynn Flewelling.
Flewelling.
F-L-E-W-E-L-L-I-N-G. It's literally
Flewelling. No, I believe you. Number three. For me, was related to my current bestsellers one. I want to read three new releases.
I want to read 10 2018 releases. At any point in 2018, if it came out in 2018, I want to read it in 2018.
My next goal is to read 10 books I already own. I should try for more, because I do want to read 60 books this year, and 10 is not that many, and I own so many books I haven't read. I'm sure you can all relate. Books are so much fun to buy, and they just take a lot longer to read.
Yeah.
I can buy so many in an instant, and it's so great.
And then read so few in so long of a time.
So I'm just going to try for 10. You know what I think?
I got Dr. Bob all over me.
You've been bobbed.
I got Dr. Bob on my skirt.
You've been Dr. Bob.
I've been Dr. Bob. I want to read 40 books that I already
40
own.
Books.
40.
You own so many books.
I own, like, a gross amount of books. I was going to make this higher, even, and then I knocked it down to 40. So of the 90 books, 40 of them. And not even, like, buying later. I mean, like, currently, right now.
Right now, at the time of making this checklist.
At the time of this, yes.
So I was going to judge you for this earlier, for being like, you have so many books. But then if you actually look at our last book haul, I bought 22 books. So I can't judge.
No, you cannot.
Number five. So for me, number five is, this is, I think the same for both of us.
Yeah.
We want to finish some series we've already started. And I haven't gone through to pick out specific series, but I know that there are a few. For me, I think it's some trilogies that I've just read the first one. But my personal goal is to finish two of them.
Okay.
Whatever series I've started, I just want to go back, pick two of them, and finish them. Get some completion going.
Yeah.
Finish two of those series.
I wanted to either continue with the series or cross it off my list.
For like everything that you've started?
Yes. And I made a list of...
That's extensive.
It's extensive, but I've started a lot of series of duologies, and like some of them have... I read the first one like several years ago. And it's like, it's coming to a point where I'm like, I need to like either continue with the series or just accept that I'm not going to.
Yeah.
So there were a few immediately that I probably already accepted a little while ago. So I went through my Goodreads and I wrote them all down. Some of them I didn't write down because I knew I was going to continue with it. So here we go! There's a
series that Rebecca will either finish or
cross off
from her life forever.
Okay, some of them are duologies. And some of them aren't finished yet, so like I just want to read the next one. Okay, so Unravel, His Fair Assassin, Shanghai Girls, Skinjacker, which is the Everlost series from Neil Schusterman, To All the Boys I Loved Before, which I have the second one, Not a Drop to Drink, Guards of the Shadowlands, Serentha Jacks, the Grimspace series.
Oh, yeah, I did keep reading that.
Yeah, Timothy Wilde, I do own the second one in that. Rotten Ruin, Wraith King by Grace Draven. The Radiance.
Yeah,
I really liked Radiance. I haven't read the next one yet.
We'll keep going together.
Yeah. The Young Elites, I really liked the first two, kind of, but I haven't read the third one yet, and, like, I just need to read it or let it go. The Waterfire Saga, that's another one where the last book came out, and I just haven't gotten to it yet. Ancillary Justice,
Ancillary Justice.
Yeah, I read the first one, and I feel like I'd have to reread the first one, because I don't really remember it. And then the Kate Daniels series.
For checklist item number 6, I would like to read 5 buddy reads.
Yeah, we want to buddy read 5 books together this year.
Yeah, we've got to pick something that, like, we know we're not going to DNF.
Yeah, because we, like, kind of tried Wild Bills, but, like, no.
We've picked a bunch of really, like, DNF books.
Yeah.
Like, books that no one should finish.
Yeah.
For number 7, I would like, personally, to read 5 books that are own voice perspectives that I haven't read before.
Yeah.
So, like, not books that I haven't read before, but, like, a specific
voice.
Perspective,
yeah.
A voice that I haven't read before, an own voice.
I just want to read 30 own voices books that are just a different voice than my own. So,
okay.
Yeah. Even if it's a perspective that I've done before. I'd probably like to do higher than that, but I'm keeping it at 30
right
now. Yeah.
For number 8, I would like to read 10 graphic novels.
I also put 10 graphic novels.
Which those could be some of our buddy reads.
Yes. I have promised that I have to read 2 Sandman novels. So 2 of them have to be Sandman.
I just really like the Sandman. Number 9 for me is a science fiction goal. And I didn't want to set just a number of science fiction novels I want to read, because I tend to just read a decent amount of science fiction in passing anyway. What I said is that I would like to read at least 1, this seems like a small number, but I'd like to read at least 1 hard science fiction. To me, that type of science fiction, hard science fiction, is speculative, it's heavy on the science, and it's less about the story, and it's more about a meaning, either social or political or environmental. There's usually, like, causes behind it, and it's always heavy on the science, which makes them very hard to read. You have a science fiction goal as well?
Yes. Not specifically hard science fiction.
Probably
zero
hard.
15 science fiction.
That's good. Number 10. For me, I want to read 5 nonfiction books.
I'm pushing myself on this one, and I put 10.
All right.
And nonfiction's not something I really read very often, but I am counting, like, autobiographies and stuff in that too, which I will pick up occasionally.
Number 11. For me, number 11 is that I would like to read 5 contemporary. I love genre fiction, and I can't help it. I just love genre fiction. But what ends up happening is I just very rarely read contemporary. What's your number 11?
I said 5 classics.
5 classics, which is sort of the opposite, where I do read some classics.
Yeah,
and
I
don't
contemporary.
Read contemporary. You read contemporary and you don't read classics.
Yeah.
Do you have
any
idea?
I kept the bar low. Probably some Jane Austen. Mm-hmm. I'll probably try to get to Frankenstein.
My 12th goal is to read 3 Horror novels. I very rarely read horror.
Some tomorrow.
I was gonna say,
I have some.
Probably borrow from you. Horror, I usually just skip because it's not comfortable to
It's kind of hard to find good horror.
Yeah.
I found books.
Yeah.
And it's hard to find something outside of, like, Stephen King.
Yeah, well, horror books don't really sell well.
You know, at the Savers near us, in the horror section, are all the Twilight novels. So just read those.
Well, those are horrific. There's got to be other good horror out there that's not the
same. Let us know. Do you have any recs?
I'm specifically looking for not Stephen King horror.
Not Stephen King horror.
I always want to like Lovecraft, but every time I start to read, like, I'm just like, I love the concepts.
I
the
know.
Writing,
whenever
I'm just
I read
not
Lovecraft, I'm like, how long have I been reading Lovecraft? It feels like an eternity, and I've read like 2 paragraphs.
Yeah. Reading Lovecraft is like walking down a very long, empty street, possibly towards the end of the world.
Was my Green Day impression good?
It's so good.
So basically, Lovecraft is that Green Day song.
Yeah.
My number 12 is to listen to 5 audiobooks.
Oh, that's a good one.
I'm not good at audiobooks. Mm-hmm. I tend to get distracted, and mm-hmm. I didn't used to have a lot of long drives, but I go to visit my family in New Jersey sometimes.
Yep, which is a bit of a drive.
It's, about 4 hours from where I am right now. And audiobooks would be great.
I have one left, and I know this isn't an issue for you. I want to do, for the whole year, 0 rereads. So I have a habit of when I don't know what to read and I just need something comfy, I will reread. So what I will say, at the time of filming this, I am rereading Philip Pullman's His Dark Materials. And I haven't read that since I was a teenager. I read it a couple times when I was a kid and then a teenager. And I haven't read it in a long time. It's a very wintry favorite for me. So I am rereading it, and I want to reread the whole series. So the rereading all 3 might go into January a little bit. So that's our 2018 checklist. Try to make your own, or, borrow ours, or there's others out there. But having even just, like, 1 or 2 goals for what you're going to read for a year can be really motivating. That is, theoretically, what our 2018 will look like.
We'll see how it goes.
Yes, we'll check in with you guys.
Yeah, we'll check in.
Here's to 2018, BookTube.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, and we'll see you in 2018. Mm-hmm.